Hi everybody, hope you are doing well. Today I am going to speak about jaw sculpting surgery. Jaw sculpting surgery is typically a narrowing of the lower jaw, where we sculpt the prominent portions of the lower jaw, like angle portions, removing a portion of meseter muscle, and at the same time the chin contouring also. It is basically done to narrow the broad or wide lower jaw, to make the lower jaw to look in proportion with the rest of the facial features and to maintain the harmony with the rest of the facial features. It's a purely an aesthetic procedure and it is a very trending procedure. The jaw sculpting is definitely different when compared to the V-line jaw surgery. Here only we are going to narrow the prominent bony portions, remove a portion of the muscle and irregularities in the lower jaw. It is entirely different from a V-line jaw surgery. Typically in the jaw sculpting, we call it as a chin sculpting, where only the chin portion, that is the front portion of the lower jaw, which we call it as a chin, we sculpt it and make it more rounder. That is number one. Number two, if any irregularities are there in the lower border of the mandible, we remove the portion of the lower portion of the mandible and we contour it. The third is we remove an angle portion, that is which is present just below the ear, here. That also we are going to remove and contour. And if some people have a very big face, the muscle also contributes to the wide face, so this we call it as a meseter muscle. We are going to remove the portion of the meseter muscle also to narrow the face. These are the different type of sculpting procedures which is usually performed on a routine basis. Well, there are two types of jaw sculpting. One is by surgical means and one is by non-surgical means. Surgical means are already discussed. In non-surgical, typically it is not a jaw sculpting only. It has been popularized by Western celebrities, where people has a double chin. We are going to be a lipolysis injections, where the fat is going to dissolve, which is present just below the chin, and makes the individual to be free from the double chin. And the second, the who has a prominent jaws, that also can be lipolysed. So this is non-surgical procedure is typically by meso lipolysis injections, where when we give injection, the fat is going to get dissolved in the body and get eliminated in the body. Only it is going to address only the two issues, one is the double chin and one is the jawline. With this, I don't think so anyone could get a proper jaw sculpting or not. Jaw sculpting, if you want to go for a proper jaw sculpting and get narrow the face, it is only by contouring the chin, removing the portion of the angle portion, removing the meseter muscle and a portion of the wide portion of the lower jaw as well. These days many people do ask me about non-surgical jaw contouring procedures. Non-surgical jaw contouring procedure is nothing but if some people have an improminent lower jaw where the lower portion of the jaw is not properly seen, to contour that we do give a bit of demo fillers to make the lower jaw much prominent and visible. And well, non-surgical jaw contouring is typically done with fillers, and sometimes we do place some sorts of implants also to get a prominent looking lower jaw. There are different type of implants, that is to contour the lower jaw, that is to enhance the lower jaw. One we call it as a chin implant. The chin implants are typically placed on the people with retruded chin to make the people to get a protruded chin. Number two is the lower border implants, which we usually place on the people with improminent lower portion of this lower jaw, this one. And the third we call it as an angle implant, some people who has an improminent a very small angle portion, then also we call it as an angle implant, which we place it here. So typically there are two types of implant, three types I guess, I'm sorry. Chin implants, lower border implants and angle implants. Based on the requirements, based on the patient requirements and all, the implants can be placed. Coming to the results of jaw sculpting, well, the results of jaw sculpting are permanent. Once the permanent portions of the lower jaw, which I already said about, the contouring of the chin has been done, the lower border, the angle portions have been removed. Definitely the results are permanent. Once the bone has been removed, the contouring is nothing but bugging of the excessive or impermanent portions of the bone. Once this has been removed, definitely the bone is not going to regrow back. Yes, the results are permanent. Coming to the cost of jazz quadring, again the cost depends on the area which we are addressing. Coming to the, if you are going for only for the chin quadring, that's a chin sculpting, is going to cost around 1 to 1.5 lakh rupees, Indian rupees. If you are going for along with the chin, you are going for the low border quadring, it's going to cost around 2 to 2.5 lakhs. If you are going for a full jaw, that is the angle, the masseter, the low border and the chin, is going to cost you way ahead, that's somewhere close to 3 lakh rupees also. Well, again, the cost again varies from country to country, surgeon to surgeon, hospital to hospital, type of anesthesia has been used. The cost is actually a controversial topic, but still people want to know about the cost. That's the reason which I am discussing over here. Well, it again depends from surgeon to surgeon. The best is the surgeon who is going to advise you on the cost.
Thank you very much. The next video I will be talking about artificial cosmetics. Thanks a lot.